What's up, everybody? It's your boy Mustache Menace at it again with yet another mastery guide, and today we're going to be going over the Humiliation Master Calling card. But before we get into it, as always, I want to thank all my current subscribers. We are currently sitting, as of this video, we are currently sitting at 200 plus subscribers. And I know it's not a lot of subscribers, but you guys mean a lot to me, and I want to thank each and every one for the great comments and suggestions. You guys are what make this channel great. And to all the new people tuning in, please consider subscribing to my channel, where I try to bring you guys the best Call of Duty tips and tricks to completing challenges and master calling cards. And if this video helps you in any way, shape, or form, don't forget to smash that thumbs up for me. It really helps the channel grow. And if you want to take it a step further, sharing is caring. Thank you, guys. And with that being said, let's get into it, y'all. First up, we got Blunt Trauma, which is get 100 Nosebreaker medals, which is kill an enemy with a gun butt. And before we get into the tactic, let's go over the class setup. For your primary, you can choose any primary that you're currently working on. You know, your best setup, your best class setup. It doesn't really matter. And for your secondary, the same thing, whatever you're working on, your best class setup, it doesn't really matter. For your tactical, I would recommend a stem shot, but in this case, we're going to be actually be using a smoke as well, and especially in Nuketown. For your lethal, Semtex, anything you're working on, doesn't really matter. For your field equipment, I would use either a field mic, proximity mine, anything you're comfortable with using. Now, your perks is what really matters. You want to be using flak jacket and tactical masks to avoid getting either grenaded or stunned or flash. For your secondary perks, you want to use scavenger so you can pick up ammo, and tracker. Tracker is going to be your best friend. Sometimes you run into the enemy spawn and, you know, tracker helps you see where they run to, what corner they're hiding in, or which way they decided to go. And of course, you want to use ghost to prevent from being seen on a UAV, and ninja. You don't want to get heard coming into the spawn before you get set up. So those two tactical perks are very, very crucial, ghost and ninja. And we're going to be tying in this tactic for multiple challenges. For instance, TikTok boom, surprise, and hit job. And the tactic is very fairly simple. Flanking and camping. That's right. We're going to be flanking and camping enemy spawns. And I found it to be easiest to do this in Nuketown, for the map is fairly small and the spawns are pretty predictable, especially in Domination. Now, I do say it's a little bit easier, but at the same time, it is also harder because the map is very, very small. Now, having said that, we're going to be utilizing smoke as a distraction or cover, and this will help you to infiltrate the enemy, where then you can set up for whatever task you're working on, be it nose breaks, point blanks, hit jobs, or even stickies. Of course, you don't have to only use Nuketown for these challenges. As long as you stick to flanking and positioning yourself in a great position, you should be able to complete these tasks. Up next, we've got Backfire, which is get 100 Backfire medals or kill an enemy with their own weapon. Now, Backfire is real simple and can be obtained by simply picking up an enemy's weapon after you kill them, of course, and trying to hunt that person down on any of your favorite game modes. But that takes forever, guys. And most of the time, if you're lucky, you'll end up with 1-2 Backfire kills and then in a 10 to 15 minute game. Such a bummer, man, I know. But I found out a way to get 8 plus Backfire kills, maybe even more depending on how good you are, in a 5 to 8 minute match using one simple game mode, which is Face Off. Very simple, since the maps are stupid small. It is 3v3. You are bound to encounter the same person multiple times. Just make sure that you kill the person first, pick up their weapon, and then just have a blast with it. And watch that challenge become history in no time. Last but not least, we have Circus Act, which is get 5 bank shot medals, basically bouncing your tomahawk off of a surface for the kill. Now, to me, this was by far the easiest challenge of the bunch. I would recommend using the exact same class setup, just change the Semtex out for the tomahawk. And another note, do not try this on hardcore. I know I like to do most of my challenges on hardcore, but if you pull out a tomahawk in hardcore, you're going to get blasted. So I would recommend any of your favorite game modes, but in specifically domination, you know, gives them something to do and it gives you the opportunity to tomahawk people while they're busy with the objective. Now, having said that, the tactic that we're going to use is basically this. We're going to go into this game pretending we are going to be playing basketball. That's right. You heard me right. Rather than a first-person shooter, we're going to be playing basketball. And what I mean by this is that anytime you see an enemy in your sight, I want you to pretend you're doing a bounce pass to him. But instead of a ball, it's going to be a tomahawk. All you do is you aim down at the floor between you and him or her and just let her rip. You won't believe how easy it is. It's actually, to me, easier than trying to hit them directly. Stupid easy. Got this challenge done on my first try. I just accidentally lost the footage somewhere, so I reenacted this to show you guys how easy it is. And hopefully this tip can help you guys complete this as soon as possible. Well, that's gonna be it for me today, y'all. I hope that y'all found this video useful or in the least a bit entertaining. Again, I want to thank all my current subscribers for all y'all's continued support. If you're new to the channel, please consider subscribing to my channel where I try to bring you the best tips in completing these calling card challenges. And if you found this video helpful in any way, shape, or form, don't forget to smash that thumbs up for me. Thanks. This is Mustache Menace. Signing off. Peace.
I'm gonna set your place on fire. Let's get higher.